kama vile tumeweza kuangalia, tulianza na the kingdom, the United Kingdom of Israel. Right? The recap nile bado ya the history. And the prophets. Okay? So we started with United Kingdom. Of Israel. Now the United Kingdom of Israel ni wakati tuko na the three kings, all right? Saul, David, and then Solomon. So that was the United Kingdom. Okay? At this time, hatuna any prophetic book that is written. We do not have either the minor or the major prophets. All right? The history is covered in the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, na pia 1 Kings, and I think partly Chronicles. Hapo ndipo unapata historia ya David, ya Saul, na Solomon. When the kingdom was one, iliitwa Israel. Na tukasema Israel ni the 12 sons of Jacob. They formed the nation of Israel. After the death of David, Solomon took over. Na Solomon, he married how many wives? David alikuwa na, I mean Solomon alikuwa na bibi wangapi? 600. I think there were 300 wives and 700 concubines. A total of 1,000. 1,000 women. Right? That was crazy. That was madness. Then, these women introduced idolatry, the worship of other gods, to Solomon. And as a result, he offended God and violated the covenant that God had, and because of him, God decided to do away with the nation. All right? But because he had a covenant with David, he spared Judah. All right? And so that is where now the kingdom is broken into two. The nation of Israel was left with 10 tribes, and Judah were left with 2. That is Judah and Benjamin. All right? Now the reason why Benjamin is also left ni kwa sababu the land or the territory of Judah was still tied to the land of Benjamin, especially in Jerusalem. So this nation was given to Jeroboam, while Judah was given to the son of Solomon, ambaye aliitwa Rehoboam. Later, this nation is exiled, so we have the end of Israel, wakati walikuwa exiled to Assyria. Na kwa niaba ya wakaaji wa Israel, kukaletwa Gentiles from the land of Assyria, and they were brought into the land of Israel. Okay. Na hao ndio tukaona wanaitwa the Samaritans. So, we were left with the land of Judah, and tukaweza kuona the capital city of Israel iliitwa of Israel. Samaria. And then Judah, Jerusalem. Na pia tulisema unaposoma Bible utakuta haya majina yakibadilishwa. There is a time we'll talk about Israel. There is a time we'll talk about Samaria. But we are talking of the same territory, same people. Okay? Kuna wakati tunaongea kuhusu Judah na kuna wakati naongea kuhusu Jerusalem. All right? Lakini pia ni vizuri tuelewe tunapoongea kuhusu Israeli. Israeli inaweza ikamaanisha the whole tribe of Jacob. Because even the Judah is in Israel. Sindio? Judah, Benjamin, they are still Israelites. Okay? But they are not in the nation of Israel. So there is Israel, the nation, the territory, and there is Israel, the sons of Jacob, the house of Jacob. So ni vizuri kutofautisha when he is speaking about the people of Jacob as Israel, and Israel, the territory, the northern kingdom that was occupied by Jeroboam, Kina Ahab, and the others. Now, after the division of the nation, that is when we started seeing God sending prophets to these people. And I think the earliest prophet to ambaye akowe recognized ni Elijah. Ambaye alikuja wakati wa Ahab. Alright? You know the story of Ahab and Jezebel. After this division, tukaanza kuona Mungu akitumia manabii kuwaonya. But at the same time, manabii walitumika kutangaza ile mpango Mungu ako nayo juu ya wanadamu. Alright? So there are two things that mainly the prophets did. One was to warn the Israelites against the violation of the covenant and the danger of disobeying God. Alright? But at the same time, God used the same prophets to speak of things that will come in the future when Christ comes. Mambo mangapi? Mawili. Now, onyo la Israeli kuhusiana na the covenant haikuhusu. Lakini, unabii ambao unalengea kuja kwa Kristo na yale mambo yatafuatia yanatuhusu. Do you understand? So, there is the historical aspect of prophecy, and there is the messianic prophecy. Whatever they would say concerning Christ. Kama tuliposoma Malachi, tuleza kuona Malachi is addressing the issues that are in the land. The evil and the disobedience that is with the priesthood. Alright? But tulipofika chapter 3, tukaona there is a prophecy about the coming of who? Of a messenger. Nayo, hiyo, ata haiwahusu wenye wanazungumziwa. That statement or that piece of information does not help them. In fact, they even don't know what to do with it. Because that would happen in the future. Alright? So, there are prophets speaking to these people, and they are addressing their stubborn, rebellious, disobedient state, while at the same time, God using those prophets to speak of the things that will happen in the future. So when they speak concerning the events and the situation in the land, it does not concern us. For example, wakati Hagai anasema waende kwa milima, wakate miti, kwa sababu wameachiria nyumba ya Bwana, hiyo haituhusu. Because hata hiyo nyumba hakuna. Na it's not part of the new covenant, it is part of the abolished covenant. You get that? So we do not have a way to implement what Hagai said. Because that was tied to the prophetic, to the historical situation on the ground. Are we together? Tukisoma mambo ya, anaitwa nani huyu, unabii mwenye aliambiwa kaoe kahaba? Hosea. Na Hosea, kuna mambo anazungumza ambayo anazungumzia the land. Okay? But kuna mambo anaambiwa afanye ambayo ni it's a prophetic illustration of what God would do with the rebellious wife. Unaelewa? So there are two aspects. There are situations and conditions in the land, but there is also the messianic message, which is what we need. Do you understand? Inakusaidia kuelewa ni mambo yapi Mungu aliahidi. Kwa mfano, when we read the book of Peter, maybe we can read 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 10 nasema, of this salvation, the prophets have inquired and searched carefully who prophesied of the grace that would come to you, searching what or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ who was in them was indicating when he testified beforehand the sufferings of Christ and the glory that would follow. You get that? So, remember, wameingia captivity, na ametoka, wame rebuild the temple, then there is a silence for around 430 years, up to the time the silence is broken by Angel Michael speaking to who? To the father of John the Baptist, Zachariah, and then finally the story of Mary came and Messiah is to be born. Okay? And so the story goes up to when the Messiah that was born was put to death. Okay? So now, when Peter is writing to a people called church. All right? Tuko pamoja? So Peter, akiandika, anaandika kukiwa na kanisa. Anaandika baada ya Kristo kuwa amekufa na amefufuka na amepaa. Sasa anaambia kanisa hivi ya kwamba kuhusu huu wokovu, manabii walitafuta kuelewa, inasema hivi, of this salvation, the prophets have inquired and searched carefully who prophesied of what? Yeah? What did the prophets? So here we have the prophets. All right? Sini sawa? Na maybe tunaweza sema the prophets wanaanza hapa. All the way to the time of Malachi. But of course we have John, ambaye ako somewhere here. Because John is the last prophet under the old covenant. Okay? Tuko pamoja? So the prophets, they prophesied of what? One, it talks about salvation. What else? So anasema, of this salvation, the prophets have inquired and searched carefully. All right? Who prophesied of what? They prophesied of the grace. They prophesied of the grace that would come to who? To who? To you. The you is? The church. Because he is speaking to the church. Alright? So the you is a pronoun standing in for the church or the believers. Okay? So he's saying to them that of this salvation, which one? The one that you have now. Okay? The prophets, they searched carefully of the grace that would come to you. Searching what manner of time the Spirit was in them was indicating when he testified before time or beforehand about the sufferings of Christ and what else? They prophesied before time, or the Spirit of Christ indicated of the sufferings of Christ before time, and the glories and the glories that would do what? And the glories that would follow. So the prophets, they prophesied about these four things. They prophesied of the salvation. They prophesied of the grace of God. All right? They prophesied about the glories that would follow the sufferings of Christ. So wakati Kristo alikuwa anakuja afe, kuna utukufu ulikuwa unafuatia. Tunaelewa? So hawa manabii, Haya ndiyo mambo walitabiri na walitamani sana kuelewa. Na hii mambo tunaongea, hii mambo Roho wa Mungu anazungumza akiwa ndani yetu, ni ya wakati upi? But at the same time, they have issues they are dealing with in the land. They are dealing with the rebellion of the people. Tuliweza kuona Zakaria and Haggai, they encouraged the people in the land. They encouraged Zerubbabel and Joshua in rebuilding the temple, isn't it? Na hapo ndipo unakuta statement kama tell Zerubbabel, it is not by power nor by might, but by my spirit. Hallelujah. Ni nini anaambia, it's not by power nor by might, but by my spirit? It is the rebuilding of the temple after captivity. Sasa wakati unatumia hiyo mustari leo, is it a messianic statement? Tell your brother. Kwanza wenye wako shule. It is not by power. That is a misuse of what is written. Ati unafanya business and in the morning you wake up, you have a prayer verse. Mambo ya prayer verse wachana nayo. If you're not, your prayer should be in line with this. A prayer that is in agreement with salvation. A prayer that is in agreement with the grace. A prayer that acknowledges the glories that was to follow the sufferings of Christ. When I'm praying, I'm talking to God, and I'm acknowledging before God that you have made me your son. You have forgiven me. You have shown mercy to me. Hello? Your prayer, your confession is in agreement with the truth. Are you getting it? And that's why when you come to the knowledge of the truth, one thing that is affected is your prayer life. Not really your prayer life, because that's when you realize you have not been praying. You have been making noise. Maombi ya nimekuja mbele yako Bwana, unarealize hiyo maombi, because it is a prayer that disagrees with the glory. What is the glory here? You have been made to sit together with him. That's a true position in Christ, right? So if you have been made to sit together with Christ, do you come before him? Lord, I am not worthy before you. I am like zege. You're getting it? So, the knowledge of what the prophets predicted inakusaidia leo kujua what is yours in Christ. Alright? Not that we tuanze ku behave kama the prophets, you know, and to do some stuff they said. Kama walisema tuvae magunia, unavaa magunia. It's them, not you. So I'm emphasizing on this one single point, that the prophets, they spoke in two ways. They spoke to the people concerning the covenant or the law that was in force. Alright? When they violated the covenant of God, God would send prophets to them to warn them of what would come after their violation. Alright? But at the same time, the Spirit of God would speak through them concerning the salvation, the grace, the sufferings of Christ and the glories that would follow. Are we together? So now, the 70 years of captivity of Judah. By the way, at this point, tunaongea kuhusu Israeli? Tunaongea kuhusu Judah na Benjamin. Tuko pamoja? So during this captivity of 70 years, na pia ni vizuri tuelewe, it didn't happen at once. They were taken in three groups. In a space of, I think, around 11 years. Group ya kwanza ni ya Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach na Abednego na wale wengine. Okay? Group ya pili ni ya kina Ezekiel the prophet. And then group ya tatu ni wale wote ambao walikawa kona nguvu. Ndiyo walibebwa. Now that is where the temple was destroyed. So when we read the story of Daniel, the story of Ezekiel, the story of who? Partly Jeremiah. Jeremiah happened to have lived before captivity and during the captivity. But the story of Jeremiah inaishia just somewhere inside, but we are not told what happened to Jeremiah, but speculation says that he died in Egypt. Okay? So story of Jeremiah inaishia hapo. So we are left with Daniel and Ezekiel, ambao ndio wali hudumu wakati huu. And they would speak to the people. But niliguzia tu kidogo tu, lakini tutaiongea maybe on a different time. Ya kwamba Daniel ideally was not a prophet. Alright? Daniel, tunaweza mwita a dreamer. Yeah? Hupati Daniel aki operate the way Ezekiel operated ama the way Jeremiah operated. Hupati Daniel akitolea watu nabii kama Jeremiah. By the way, while Jeremiah was in Jerusalem and Daniel was in Babylon, Daniel was still depending on the prophecies that were given to by Jeremiah to the people in captivity. Alright? Na ndio ukisoma Daniel chapter 9, Daniel is just reading the letters that were coming from Jeremiah, and he understood by reading the prophecy of Jeremiah that the time of captivity is over. And that's why he began to pray for the 21 days. Tuko pamoja? Yeah, so Daniel, tutaangalia story yake, is a bit interesting. But you find a lot of what God would do during this period is captured by Daniel. Kuna mambo mengi ambayo Mungu ali reveal ambayo yanatukia baada ya Kristo kuja. The desolation of the same nation of Judah. You know, the issue of the destruction of the city, vitu kama hizo. Tutaangalia hiyo a different time. Now, last week, we looked at the story from here. Okay? Understanding this dispensation of how many kings? About four kings of Persia. Baada ya captivity in Jerusalem, the land of, or rather the nation of Judah never returned as a nation again. All right? Tunaelewa? They were controlled by Gentile nations. Na hapa tunaona the king of Babylon controlling the land of Judah. Okay? After the king of Babylon was overthrown by the Medi-Persia, then tunaona the king of Medi and the Persian wakiwa sasa ndio wana control. So wakati tunasoma story ya Ezra na Nehemiah, tunasoma historia ya Juda wakiwa chini ya utawala wa ufalme wa Persia. Okay? Tuko pamoja? And later Daniel had prophesied that there are four kingdoms that will rise. The first one was the kingdom of Babylon that was existing during the time of Daniel. Okay? After the kingdom of Babylon, the kingdom of Persia was to come. Na sasa, ndio wakati wa Nehemiah na kina Ezra. Alright? After the kingdom of Persia, another kingdom would rise up, which was the kingdom of Greece. And after that, there was the fourth kingdom, ambao ni the kingdom of Rome. Sasa hayo ni baadhi ya mambo Danieli alionyeshwa. Na it began with the statue of Nebuchadnezzar. You remember the statue? Yeah? Ile statue ilikuwa na the head of gold, the chest of silver, the belly of brass, and the iron. Na kule chini iron mix, ikiwa mixed. Okay? You should not be scared when you read the book of Daniel. The book of Daniel is simply a calendar in simple language. Kitabu cha Danieli ni calendar ya jinsi the kingdoms will rise from this to this, from here to here. All right? And by the way, for us to be able to understand the book of Revelation, we must understand the book of Daniel. Without the book of Daniel, the book of Revelation is irrelevant. So, wakati wa kina Nehemiah, tunaongea kuhusu the kingdom of Persia. Otherwise, Judah is no longer a nation. Na hatuna wafalme pale, tuko na governors ambao wako chini ya utawala wa the Persian. Okay? And that's where we have the kings of Persia, starting with King Cyrus, who made a decree that the temple should be rebuilt in Jerusalem. All right? After Cyrus, tuko na nani mwingine? Ahasuerus, ambaye ndiye mume wa Queen Esther. Ahasuerus, utakuta pia naitwa Xerxes. Alright? After Ahasuerus, we have Artaxerxes. And then from Artaxerxes, ndio tuko na? Darius. Okay? So the history chani ndo hii. So having the 70 years there, and we have the return from captivity. So hiki kipindi ni cha kurudi kwa the captivity, the captors. Na by the way, hawakurudi wote. Ni wale ambao walienda kujenga the temple and they were few. Otherwise, mpaka during the time of Nehemiah, tunaona kwanza Nehemiah anatoka wapi? Anatoka Shushan, ambayo sio Israeli. He's coming from work. Alright? Kwa sababu hiki kipindi chote, the nation of Judah is under the rule of Persia. Right? So, we have the four kings, Cyrus. We have Ahasuerus. We have Zexas, Artaxerxes. And then we have Darius. Okay? So, these are Persian, yeah? Persian kings who ruled the land. Okay? In Jerusalem, there were two main activities that took place during this time. One, yeah? Rebuilding temple, and number two, the wall. So, haya ndio mambo mawili muhimu ambayo yalitendeka baada ya wao kutoka captivity. Waliporudi. In fact, the reason ya wao kurudi ni kwa sababu ya King Cyrus kuwa authorized na Mungu a rebuild the temple. That was the single reason why the few Jews returned to Jerusalem. Kina Ezra, kina Joshua, kina Zerubbabel. Yeah? And we have the list, you'll find that in I think the first chapter of Ezra. Tuko pamoja? Yeah? Now, when Cyrus made the decree, the temple yanze kujengwa, the people who occupied the northern kingdom, they started frustrating the children of Israel who returned from captivity. They started to frustrate them from the days of Cyrus all the way to the time of Darius, isn't it? Tunashika. Lakini, when we read the book of Esther, hapa, the book of Esther inatupatia a historical view ya the kind of oppression that was happening. Alright? Hapo ndipo tunapata story ya mtu kama Haman ambao amepanga kumaliza all the Jews. Naye Mungu anamtumia Esther so that the king can stop the plan of Haman, isn't it? Now, you, by the way, if you have never read the book of Esther, you need to read. Okay? Hata sidhani kama kuna mahali inaongea sana. I don't know whether he may mention mambo ya Mungu. It's just a history of the Jews in Persia. The kind of life they lived, the way the king would just go out and capture the women, you know, the girls from the Jewish community, take them to the Paris, train them as his own wives, and that's how Queen Esther landed there. What was the name of Esther? Aliitwa Hadasa. Hadasa ndio jina lake la Kiyahudi. The Jewish name ni Hadasa. Kwa nini alibadilisha jina? Kwa sababu hakutaka kujulikana he is a Jew. So aliyejua jina yake Hadasa ni nani? Ni anko yake Mordekai. Tunaelewa? And then kwa sababu ya hiyo unaona mfalme amewekwa in suspense kwa sababu hajui ya kwamba Esther is a Jew. Up to until wakati ana reveal the secret ya this man Haman ambaye amepanga kinyume na the Jews, isn't it? Ndio Esther akasema ama Jew. And this man has planned evil against us and our people. All right? Yes. And that's where we are able to see the kind of oppression and the frustration that the Jews were going through during this time. Okay? Then, wakati wa Artaxerxes, tunaona the rebuilding ile kazi ya mjengo, because of the letter that had been written, the work was stopped. Na hakujenga tena, up to until wakati wa Darius, and this is where wakati wa Darius, hapa ndipo tunaona Haggai and Zechariah, the prophet, being used by God to encourage Zerubbabel and Joshua so that they can resume the rebuilding of the temple. All right? Na hapo ndipo tuliona tusoma Haggai anasema hawa watu anasema it's not yet time to rebuild the house of God. Na akaambiwa mujihadhari, mujiangalie vizuri. Mnapanda nyingi, mnavuna kidogo, mnakula hamshibi, mnakunywa hamtosheki, na wale ambao wanapata mshahara inaingia kwenye mifuko yenye mashimo, na wanaoleta kidogo nyumbani ninaipuliza. Kwa sababu gani? You have neglected my house. And that's where God tells them through Haggai, enendeni kwa mlima mkate miti munijengee nyumba that I may find pleasure in it. Hallelujah. Na tukaweza kuona ya kwamba hiyo haina uhusiano na kanisa la Kristo today, because ile nyumba ilikuwa inajengwa ni ile nyumba ambayo ilikuwa imeagizwa Moses kwa mlima, ambayo ilijengwa with a specific pattern. Alright? Ikajengwa na Solomon, ikabomolewa na Nebuchadnezzar, na ndio hiyo inaanza kuwa rebuild na Zerubbabel. Are we together? So that house, we don't have it today. Actually, It was destroyed in 70 AD, na hiyo ndiyo nyumba Yesu alisema, hakuna jiwe litabaki juu ya lingine. You understand? So mtu hawezi simama leo, aseme mumeachilia nyumba ya Bwana. Why? Kwa sababu katika agano jipya, Mungu hatumii nyumba zimejengwa kwa mawe. Hallelujah. Sasa we are the house of God. We are the temples of God. God resides in us. He resides in men. Which was not the case during this time. Tunaelewa? So mtu kutumia Hagae ati mumeatiria nyumba ya Bwana. Pengine waseme mumeachiria kiosk, siku hizi hamununui. Mmekataa kuwa wateja mtoi taifa. Yeah? Lakini that has nothing to do with the Church of Jesus Christ. The Church of Jesus Christ is not a place. Can I repeat that? The church is not a place but a people that have believed in Jesus, a people that have been called out of the world. That people, when they meet, the church has met. The church has gathered. Alright? So, swali la unaenda kanisa wapi is a ridiculous question. A question that is projected from the platform of religious mindset. Yeah? It is the church that goes to a place. The church does not go to church. Is it clear? So hii nyumba ambayo ilikuwa inajengwa wakati wa kina Ezra na kina Joshua na Zerubbabel. These two prophets, they were used at that time to speak to the condition of the land. Alright? Ambayo, it is not a condition that is there today. God does not use that house anymore. We don't have it. Hata ukienda Jerusalem, iyo nyumba haiko. I think ile waliachiwa ni ukuta. Inaitwa the Wailing Wall. Huh? Which they think that is the wall ambayo ilikuwa ya the temple. But I don't think so. The temple is not there. Nyumba ya Bwana hakuna. Nyumba ya Bwana ni wewe katika agano jipya. So, Haggai and Zechariah, they speak during this time. Then after the temple was built, the wall was still damaged, destroyed, there were no gates. Na hapo ndipo sasa tunarudi tunaona Nehemiah. Nehemiah anakuja ku rebuild ama kumoborize the rebuilding of the walls. Okay? The temple is already finished now, lakini the walls ziko chini. Na ndio tunaona pia Nehemiah anajaribu kuleta the order, because the Levites wanakuwa neglected, because the priest in charge is a corrupted priest. He has substituted the storehouse for someone's bedroom. Tuliona anaitwa nani? Yeah? Eliashib. Eliashib was the high priest ambaye alikuwa mecorroborate na a Gentile, na nampatia the temple, the storehouse, iwe mali pake pakulala na kukaa. So when Nehemiah comes from Shushan, he finds the evil that Eliashib had committed, and he threw the things that Tobias inje, ordered the house, the temple to be cleaned, And then he brought the Levites and positioned them in their place. Naka mobilized the people wanze kuleta the offerings ambazo walitakiwa kuleta into the in the temple, isn't it? Na sasa hapo ndio tunaona another prophet rising ambaye anaitwa Malachi. Malachi anakuja ku address the issue in the land. Which issue? The issue with the priesthood. Okay? Because the priesthood is completely corrupted. The priesthood have rejected God. The priesthood, they actually insulting God in their ways of doing things. They are offering to God lame and sick animals as sacrifices, and considering that the table of the Lord is not important. You know, they have intermarried with Gentiles. Sasa hizo ndizo issues Malachi anashughuliki. So when he says bring in the whole tithe into the storehouse, Malachi is not talking about the people. He's not talking to the people. He's talking to the priesthood of that time that have become corrupted. Na wameondoa mpaka the tithe kwa the storehouse. Now we are not told what he used to do with it. But one thing we see from Nehemiah chapter 12 is that when he came back, he discovered that the Levites had gone back to their businesses, because the food, the portion that was supposed to be given to them, hakupatiwa. Sasa shida ilikuwa wapi? Nani alikuwa mwizi wa tithe? The high priest. Wakiwa mekorabolete na nani? Na Tobias, na Sanbarat, na wale wengine. So, tukisoma hizi vitabu, tutakuta mambo ambayo hayahusu kanisa la Kristo. Kwa sababu gani? Ni mambo yanayohusiana na the events ambayo ilikuwa na happen in the land at that particular time. But there is a prophetic or there is a messianic prophecy in these books. Kuna mambo walizungumza ambayo haihusu the people they were talking to. It was to happen in the future. We have this gap of 430 years where the Messiah comes and he dies. Kama vile tumeona the prophets, they prophesied of the salvation, the grace, the sufferings of Christ, and the glory that would follow. So tukisoma Malachi, we will find the prophecy about the things that were to follow. Do you understand? A messenger who will come. Now maybe tutaisoma next week, we'll see that. Inaeleweka? So tuelewe ya kwamba tunaposoma the historia ya return from captivity, tuko na Gentile kings ambao wanatumika kutupatia timeline. Cyrus, Ahasuerus, Artaxerxes na Darius. Okay? Now, something very important. Ukisoma the book of Ezra, tunakuta Ezra amemention Nehemiah. Alright? Tunapata Ezra amemention Haggai. Tunapata Ezra amemention nani? Zechariah. Tukisoma kitabu cha Nehemiah, again, we find Nehemiah mentioning Ezra. Why? Because they are operating at the same time. All right? When you read the book of Malachi, you find the same stories, the same issues that Nehemiah is dealing with. They are the same issues that Malachi is raising. Na sasa hiyo inatusaidia kuweza kurelate hizi vitabu tunazosoma na the history of the land. And that was the main purpose ya kusoma hili somo, so that you can understand the connection between the history and the prophets. Any question? Yeah? Ezra was a scribe. A scribe walikuwa ni waandishi. Okay? He was a scribe kama Baruch. Baruch was a scribe. Yeye ndiye aliandika whatever Jeremiah was prophesying. Okay? Na sasa yeye alihusika sana katika kuelekeza this Jews who returned, aliwaelekeza katika sheria, kwa sababu he was conversant with the law of Moses. Nehemiah naye alikuwa mfanyikazi katika nyumba ya mfalme. Actually ndiye alikuwa anasip the juice ya mfalme kutest whether iko sawa. All right? So he was just a worker. But later you find them as governors in different times. Nehemiah is not a prophet. Ezra is also not a prophet.
The only prophet is Haggai.
The only prophet ni Haggai na
Zechariah
na Malachi. Right? Those are prophets. Lakini hawa wengine mpaka kina Zerubbabel, kina Joshua, they are just common people. Joshua was from the tribe of Levi. That's why he is the high priest. Nae Zerubbabel was in the lineage of Josiah, the lineage of the kings. That's why he is appointed as the governor in the land. Ahasuras. Yes. In fact, the reason why he is mentioned, na story yake imekuwa mentioned, ni kwa sababu ya Queen Esther. Otherwise, how wengine, we don't have much information about them unless you go to the history of Persia. Ndio tuelewe ni nini walikuwa nafanya, walikuwa metoka wapi. So, information yao ni irrelevant katika the story of the Bible. Because the story of the Bible is basically not even about the Israel, but about the coming of Christ. If you can remember the journey of the seed. Okay? Yeah, so we are just given portion of information that is only relevant to that history that we are being given. Kama sasa tukisoma the book of Daniel, kwa mfano, tunajua mambo ya Nebuchadnezzar, na tunajua story ya Belshazzar. Only two kings in the book of Daniel ambao wako mentioned. From Babylon. Sindio? They are only mentioned because of the times Daniel is receiving the vision. Otherwise, they were not the only kings who ruled Babylon during this time of captivity. Tunaelewa? Lakini hatupatiwi stories za hao wengine. Kina Ivo Merodach. We are not given their stories because it's not relevant to the story of in the book of Daniel. Okay? Lakini ukienda the book of Jeremiah, utakuta those other kings that were between Nebuchadnezzar and Belshazzar. Okay? na pia the Book of Chronicles.
Hapa kuna story, tulikuwa tuna story ya prophets, prophets wakali waliingilia, na bado kuna kings. Hawa kings walikuja after captivity.
Kings wagani? Hawa?
Kuna hawa kings na kuna hawa prophet. Kuna prophet na kuna kings.
Yes,
Hapa wakati hizi tribe zili split, zile zienda 10 na 4 na 2, wakati wa Judah, ndio wakaenda to captivity. After wali return, kulikuwa na kings.
Okay, wacha turudi nyuma kidogo eh. Ini lineage gani?
Sasa tuko
ini line ya nani? Tunaongea kuhusu taifa gani hili? History yote. This is Judah. Yes, is how. Then tunafika mahali the nation was split. Ndio tunakuta Israel. Israel after some time waliisha. Walibebwa na wakapelekwa into the foreign land, and their story is gone up to all this time. Hawako hata wakati wa Yesu. All right, so tuko na prophet ambao waliwazungumzia. Yes, they spoke to Israel, na tuko na prophet who spoke to Judah, kama Daniel, kina Nehemiah, kina Haggai, Zechariah, they spoke to Judah. Jeremiah spoke to Judah. Isaiah spoke to Judah. Okay? Hapo umeshika? Na baada ya King Nebuchadnezzar kuingia Jerusalem, mambo ya kings in Jerusalem ikaisha. The last kings walikuwa watoto wa Josiah, ambao walikuja wakashikwa wakawekwa kama governors. Na when they rebelled, he came and killed them. Na moja, I think ni Joakim, wakaenda akafungwa in Babylon. Nashika. So from that time, hatuna kings wa Israeli, because hakuna, kings of Judah, because Judah is now under the Persian kingdom. So tuko tu na governors, Zerubbabel na hata Nehemiah at one point is a governor, hivo. So Israeli hakuna wafalme. Yes.
Toka hiyo tembe ilijengwa na kimsoma. Iko mbele. Na hiyo kine zidi ejeje. Ndio tunaita tena kalikuwa kwa captivity.
Ya King Solomon ilijengwa hapa. Wacha tu tuweke hapa. Hiyo ni wakati wa Solomon, ambayo ndio inakuja kubomolewa hapa. This is somewhere here. Hii sasa ndio inakuja inabomolewa. Okay? Then Zerubbabel anajenga nyingine hapa. Ambayo haunge compare na hii. Hapa ndio tunaona wakati msingi wake unamaliziwa. Wazee ambao waliona hii wanalia. Nao vijana ambao hawakuona hii wanashangilia. So you could not compare the Zerubbabel's temple na Solomon's temple. Baada ya Nehemiah, story ya Israeli ya Juda inaisha. Wanaingia into the rule of the Gentiles. Kwa sababu after the kingdom of Persia, where watu kama Nehemiah, kina Mordecai, kina Esther walijulikana, then another kingdom arose, which is the kingdom of Greece. When that kingdom came, now the story ya Israeli inakuwa another story. Okay? So during this time, hapo ndipo, you know, the kingdom of Greece wange persecute the Jews. Now that is in the history, you don't find it in the Bible. To appoint the Jews would reverse the circumcision. Unaenda unafanyiwa operation tena ndio uwe uncircumcised. Sijui kama unashika hiyo. Ndio uweze kusurvive. It was just terrible, and that's why you narudi unapata the battle of the Maccabees. That way you will find in the history, because haiko kwa Biblia. Na sasa hapo ndipo the temple ya solo ya nani Zerubbabel inakuwa renovated by Herod. Herod anachukua usukani as a king of the Jews. Later, na ndio sasa tunamuona pande hii as the king of the Jews, ambaye hatambuliki sana because still Judah is under tribute by the Romans. Naelewa? Sasa hiyo ndio ilijengwa na ikapanuliwa, it didn't follow, by the way, the order ambayo ilipatiwa Moses. Hapo ndipo ilijengwa mpaka kukawa na Gentiles courts, women's court. Those things didn't exist. Solomon's porch, they didn't exist in the temple and in the design ambayo ilipatiwa Moses ama ilitumika kujenga wakati wa Solomon, nor the time of Zerubbabel. Na hiyo ndio ilikuwa imetengenezwa mpaka na dhahabu, na hiyo ndio temple Yesu alisema itabomolewa na hakuna jiwe litabaki juu ya lingine. Now that happened in 70 AD. So from that time atujakuwa na nyumba ya Bwana. Nyumba ya Bwana ikaishia hapo.
The Rapture Church and the former church.
Mm.
Which church?
I've said before, when you quote a verse, before you ask, read that verse in context. Ndio uweze kujua what we are talking about, because it has nothing to do with the church of Jesus Christ. Now, by the way, hiyo verse iko wapi? Haggai 2:9, isome. Because hii wakati wote, we do not have church. Hapa hakuna kanisa. Right? Haggai chapter 2, verse 9 inasema,
the glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, says the Lord of hosts, and in this place will I give peace, says the Lord of hosts.
The glory of
this latter house.
The glory of this latter temple, ama latter. So church inakujia wapi hapa? Hiyo mustari ilitoka wapi? The glory of this church shall be, where did you find that in the Bible? The glory of this latter temple shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will give peace, says the Lord of hosts. Nisome version nyingine.
The latter glory of this house will be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I shall give the ultimate peace and prosperity.
So, which one are we talking about, the church? kuna mahali Biblia inasema utukufu wa kanisa la mwisho itakuwa kubwa kuliko ya iko
the future glory of this temple will be greater than its past.
So we are talking about the temple, we are not talking about the church. All right, so mwenye alikuja na mawazo ya kwamba Hagai Mungu anazungumza kuhusu kanisa. We have two temples now. We have the temple of Solomon and we have the temple of Zerubbabel. We have the last future temple which is called the third temple. Na hiyo ikijengwa kanisa halitakuwa hapa. All right? But to be on point, there is nothing in the Bible like the church, the glory of the church shall be. Meshika, somebody confused the temple and the church. Na ndio nikasema, when you read a verse, ukisikia uko na swali, mahali hiyo swali inatoka, enda hapo kwanza soma kwa Bible, uelewe ni nini nazungumziwa. Lest you ask a wrong question. Because if you ask a wrong question, if a question is built from a wrong premise, even the answer is wrong. Alright? Tumeshika? Yeah. Na that's why nahimiza watu wasome Bible. Tuachane na mistari na vitu zingine ambazo zimefundishwa ambazo haziko kwa Bible. Amen? And now may the grace and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. You are blessed.